Hello everyone, welcome again to another episode of the Wheel of the Year. This video is all about the Festival of IMBOLC. I'm Harmony, and thank you for watching. IMBOLC, also known as Candlemas, and commonly known and celebrated as Groundhog's Day, is always usually celebrated on February 2nd. This day falls right smack dab in between winter solstice and equinox. It is the midpoint between those 2 days and holds a lot of power because of that. It is a day when nature starts to feel the rustling of spring coming again. And it is a time where we, in turn being part of nature, start to feel that rustling of the bulbs underneath the ground start to come forth, and those desires or those goals, those things that we are embodying and creating into this world start to come forth, and we can start to really embody those things that we have meditated upon and visualized and experienced in our past. And so, being the point between the winter solstice and autumn equinox in the northern hemisphere, it is also a time where the animals start to come out of hibernation, and we start to see some animals start to let down their milk, and hence some people relate IMBOLC in milk to each other. And it is also a time, like I said, the bulbs are starting to rustle. Some of them are actually starting to peek through the ground. They're starting to push up and see the light again. And it's also a time where many chickens and birds are starting to lay eggs again after a cold winter, if they've gone dormant. I've actually had this experience several IMBOLCs where I've gone out and the chickens have laid their first eggs, and it's been really an exciting experience after a cold winter of not having eggs and feeding the chickens and taking good care of them to see them happy and the signs of spring coming again. And because it's the signs of spring, and we often see the story of the groundhog, this is, you'll see the groundhog comes out of hibernation, and then if he sees his shadow, then he decides that it's going to be an extended cold winter, and he's going to go back down and he's going to hibernate some more. But if he doesn't see his shadow, he says, oh, it's going to be a early spring and I don't need to go hibernate anymore. So it's kind of a cool story, and I found this really old ancient Gaelic story about this old winter hag. She's the divine hag of winter, named Caelic, I think I'm saying it right, I'm not sure. And she would go out, and if it was a beautiful day, she would, on IMBOLC, she would go gather her sticks and her kindling for her fires for the extended winter to come. And if it was not a beautiful day, if it was rainy and cold, she would decide to stay in, and she would burn the rest of the kindling and the wood that she had collected over the winter, and that would be the end of winter. And she would decide that to come out, and she would no longer be the representation of the energy for the moment, and spring would come. She's kind of like the winter fairy that decided to bring spring after all. So this also goes hand in hand with Saint Brigid, and Saint Brigid is a really fascinating deity of IMBOLC, and she is connected to wells and water and the wellspring of creation, and she's also connected to fire and forging and alchemy, and this forging of new energies and new life by fire. And so this is a great time to create alchemy with fire, and this is a really fun way to celebrate IMBOLC and to honor Brigid. And the energies of alchemy and fire and ice. And this is an ice candle holder. And I will show you how to make one of these in a later video. Just a really beautiful, fun way to put your intentions into the fire and the ice and honor IMBOLC and the energies of this time at the same time. Another wonderful way to honor Brigid is by creating a Brigid's cross out of grasses, which I'll show you how to make also, or a bride doll, a Brigid doll, St. Brigid corn doll. And this is one my daughter made. It's so beautiful. I absolutely love this one. I thought I'd share it with you. Put it on the altar. So, wonderful ways to celebrate this time of year is to go out and have a nature walk and gather things to create your candles, to create your incenses, to create your bride dolls, to create wands like the Divine Hag of Winter. Go and gather sticks for your hearth and for your altar. Create a sacred space and decorate your altar with things that you've gathered along your nature walks and your journeys. An IMBOLC altar is a really good way to really put in your intentions into a manifest form, into a physical reality, and that will help further your connection to nature and further your connection to the cycles of the wheel of the year, and also to your intuition and your inner cycles as well. Connecting to your inner self, meditations are a really powerful way to honor IMBOLC and the energies of the season. It is a wonderful way to go in and do water meditations, go into the well, journey deep within the well and the wellspring of your inner creations and find out what your next creations are going to be. Do meditations for fire and finding the fire that keeps you driven and the next things you're going to be forging in the fires. It is a really beautiful way to celebrate this time of the year. Do meditations where you're going within. Do meditations with global connections. And I'll put some links for some meditations down in the description box. Another wonderful way to celebrate this time of year is by incense making. Making your own incense, making your own candles, making your own wands. These are wonderful ways to really put intention into physical items that you can further use on further rituals or in your IMBOLC ritual itself and on your altar. It is a very, very powerful time to set new intentions. Seed planting, planting the seeds physically, planting the seeds energetically, spiritually. It is a time for really planting and thinking about the new visions that you have to come. Planting your intentions and planting real seeds. Start a little garden inside if it's still really cold outside. If it's not that cold and you're in a warmer climate, start planting your seeds for the years outside. And you can also put the seeds in your mouth and add a little bit of your DNA to the seed, and it will help customize whatever nutrients you need from the soil or even energetic things. It's a great way to connect and to really personalize your gardening experience. And remember that we are gardens, so plant good seeds within yourself. And really celebrate this time of year. Have fun with it. Really enjoy the time of IMBOLC. And happy planting. Blessed be. I hope you enjoy this video. Stay tuned for more videos on the Wheel of the Year. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more. Have a great day.